for the past couple of months, we've been talking about something so near and dear to my heart, thriving with type 2 diabetes, you know, and preventing heart disease and stroke. So with me today is an inspirational CEO leading one of the largest voluntary health organizations around. I am so pleased to welcome to the Donnie McClurkin Show my friend, Tracey D. Brown, CEO of the American Diabetes Association. Welcome to the show, dear.
Donnie, Pastor, it is always my pleasure to have the opportunity to spend some time with you. Thank you so much for having me today. And you're so right. Diabetes in this time period specifically is such an important conversation right now. And I'm glad to hear you talk about thriving, because I too am thriving with type 2 diabetes.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'm telling you, and that's the mindset that we've got to take, that it is not just living with it, but it is thriving. We have ways of overcoming and becoming so aware and educated on how to live so that we can prevent all of the different side effects that go along with diabetes, including heart attack and strokes, because these are some key things that diabetics have got to be careful with. But before I go further, you know, how have you been, you know, with this different change of climate, the time, the pandemic, how have you been?
You know, thank you for the question, Pastor. You know, I'm just praising God that my family and I are well and good amongst this craziness, the pandemic, the social and racial unrest in this country that is happening. You know, we are staying well, staying safe, and staying connected and aligned. And I'm grateful for that. And I hope you are doing the same.
Yeah. Yeah, I am. And I'm being much more careful with my health than I have ever been in my entire life, because things are changing all around us. Everything is changing with this pandemic, like you said, with the social and the racial craziness that's going on. And self-health care for me has become really important. You know, one thing that hasn't changed is really how important it is to manage our health. It is important. And in fact, when you look at everything, you know, from the media to conversations around our family tables, health is like this top of mind subject more than ever before.
Donnie, you know, we were just talking about this the other day, that you can't talk about improving the health and well-being of Americans in this country without having a conversation about diabetes, given the pervasiveness of diabetes. You can't talk about improving the health and well-being of Americans in this country without actually talking about the health inequities that have plagued this country. And you can't talk about improving the health and well-being of Americans in this country without talking about the link between diabetes and heart disease. And let me just layer one more thing on that. The people who are disproportionately affected by all of this are people with color. So you're absolutely right. Health and well-being right now at this moment in time couldn't be more important.
You know, like so many other things, you know, better health starts, you know, with a single step and then another and then another. It is being consistent. You know, you mentioned type 2 diabetes and heart disease, which, you know, is the link we've been talking about for the last couple of months. But your organization and the American Heart Association, they teamed up to tackle these serious health issues together. So tell me why that came about.
Two great organizations decided to come together to take on what this is a health crisis in this country. And it was before the pandemic, Donnie. So we came together mainly because of this fact. When you look at the number one complication from diabetes, it is heart disease, stroke, some kind of issue related to that. In fact, every 2 minutes, somebody is having some kind of heart-related issue or stroke from complications from diabetes. So yeah. 2 years ago, we came together to pull together a program with some key sponsors to do a couple of things. One is to really reach down to the people living with diabetes and those who love and take care of us to educate on this connection and link between diabetes and heart disease. In fact, Donnie, 50%, half of the people who are age 44 and above don't understand the connection between diabetes and heart disease. So we wanted to get out there with some education, tools, and resources, and also work in concert with the healthcare professionals to make sure that they have tools and resources that they need as well. We have got to get ahead of this thing, Donnie.
And you're right, because I didn't know the connection between heart disease and stroke. I've been living with and just starting to thrive through diabetes for the last 15 years. It's been 15 years. And I'm just finding out about the real connectivity between heart disease and stroke now through your organizations conjoined. This has really revolutionized the way that I think, because sometimes you think yourself to be so impervious, you know, and you, just because you don't feel badly at the time, you don't realize the damage that's taken place. My concern and my attention was on neuropathy, you know, kidneys, vision, but it was never on heart disease or stroke. And this has been really informing. It's been helping me to understand that the older I get, the more I've got to take responsibility for how I live, what I do, and how I combat this situation.
That's exactly right. And so you just pressed on a couple of things that I always want to press on. And that is, Donnie, we have more power and control than we think we do. And when you actually get the knowledge mm-hmm. around all of these things, like heart disease, kidney, liver, eyes, these are all complications from diabetes, but we don't have to succumb to them. Right. And this is what No Diabetes by Heart is about. We've got to be mindful of what we're eating. We've got to be mindful of our physical exercise and activity. We've got to be mindful of our stress, Pastor. We've got to be mindful of our sleep. All of these things actually contribute to influencing our blood sugars, but yeah. we have more control than we think. So that's what it's about. And I want to make sure that everyone is aware and understands that taking these small steps, like you talked about, yeah. make a world of difference.
November is, you know, American Diabetes Month. Yes. And, you know, I'm a November baby. Praise God for Jesus. So what's next for No Diabetes by Heart?
So we have a lot of things. And again, as you say, November is Diabetes Awareness Month. And so I do want to make sure that everyone who's watching and listening, that you go check your numbers, check your blood glucose, make sure that you understand what your A1Cs are. But we are going to be rolling out a campaign for Diabetes Awareness Month. And for No Diabetes by Heart, we're about to be rolling out our new set of ambassadors for the program. And these are people who are thriving while living with diabetes as well. I think you had one of our ambassadors on Hi-Vel not that long ago.
Yeah, yeah.
So we've got the new set of ambassadors that will be enrolling and joining us to really share their testimony about how they're living, how they're thriving, and the things that they are doing. And I want to encourage everyone to make sure during Diabetes Awareness Month, you go to nodiabetesbyheart.org and right. get on our email, follow the activities that we have going on. This is the month. If you haven't taken your diabetes seriously, or you're one of the millions of people who don't even understand that you have diabetes, mm-hmm. I want to get it on your radar in November. Let's do it, and let's do it together.
I've been dealing with members in their late 20s, early 30s, that are discovering that they're diabetic. You know, because, you know, our American food, well, you know, it's geared to lead us in that direction. I'll just say that. And they have, because they're new with this, they have so many questions. So if they go to nodiabetesbyheart.org, can they ask questions? Is there an availability on that site to be able to type in your questions and get an answer back?
Yes, yeah, so they should go to the site, and we also have a Ask the Expert series as well. But there is a plethora of information there, Donnie, and places to interact so that anyone can get their questions answered around the link between diabetes and heart disease. I will also say there's a plethora of information if you go to diabetes.org as well. There should not be an instance where people can't reach out and get their questions answered. This is what it's all about. And don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
The more you know, the more you'll be able to get ahead of this thing. And please remember, your endocrinologist is important. Your dietitian is important. And your primary care health giver is important to network you with the different other specialists that will give you information on how to go forward. And that linked up with nodiabetesbyheart.org, that should be enough information to cause you to rise up above this thing and live healthily to the ripe old age of 175. Amen. But I want to thank you so much, Tracey. Listen, let me just leave this opening right quickly for you to give a little bit of your story, a little bit of your testimony. And this is above and beyond what we're supposed to be talking about, but your testimony shook me to a point of awareness that I was literally taking for granted. So just take a minute and, no, not even a minute. Take as long as you want and just give Tracey Brown's experience.
Yes, so Donnie, I was diagnosed 17 years ago with gestational diabetes. When I was pregnant with my daughter. And for 80% of the women, once you have your baby, usually the diabetes goes away. I was in that 20% minority. Now, I should have taken the diagnosis seriously. I had a beautiful baby girl. The doctors told me that my diabetes didn't go away. In fact, it turned into type 2 diabetes. And I was like, sure, no problem. Like you said it before, I feel good. I feel fine. I should have taken it seriously, and I didn't. So for 5 years, Donnie, I didn't really change much of anything. My daughter would see me take my insulin shots every day. She'd see me prick my finger to take my blood glucose. And one day, she was 5 years old. We were in the bathroom. I'll never forget it. We were getting dressed. She looked at me and said, Mommy, are you going to die from diabetes? Wow. That changed my life completely. And I made a commitment right there in that bathroom to myself, to my daughter, to my family, that I was not going to die from diabetes. And in fact, I was going to become the poster child of how you thrive with diabetes.
Yeah,
and I
would
unapologetically tell my story as much as I possibly could as my own form of driving awareness.
Good Lord. Okay, I'm about to go into other conversations because, you know, I'm thinking about every aspect of becoming well. I'm thinking about every aspect. And the American Diabetes Association hooked up with the American Heart Association. This is the totality of my existence right now. My heart, my blood sugar levels, my blood pressure, all of this is key to me moving on. My vision has been impaired. And so my thing is, okay, I've got to get my vision back up to snuff. My health is feeling good, but my blood sugar levels are erratic. So now what I've got to do is go to nodiabetesbyheart.org. And I'm very serious. I'm not doing this for a plug. because I'm doing this because this is information available to me. Whereas if I can't call my doctor at all times, at least I can go to a site where I can find out some pertinent information about my journey as I thrive through diabetes. I have to be informed. I've come to the realization after all this time, I have to be informed.
Information is power, Donnie. And I just want to put a pin on what you just said. Go to knowdiabetesbyheart.org. I'm grateful and thankful, Donnie, that you're sharing this because this is about driving awareness. We need more people to understand so that they can actually take control and do something different with their behavior. So I'm grateful to you that you're even helping us spread this message. I'm grateful that the American Heart Association and the American Diabetes Association kind of linked together to bring even more forward. And I'm grateful and thankful for our sponsors, BI Lilly, Novo Nordisk, AstraZeneca, Sanofi, Bayer, all of these organizations coming together to help us continue to drive awareness so people know the link between diabetes and heart disease.
I want you to know from my heart that I thank you for taking this time to help all of us that are on this journey. I don't want anybody that's listening to this to be so impaired or die from something that we can control. I don't want anybody who is watching to get to the point of defeat, even if they have debilitated to a degree where they're concerned. I want them to know that there's hope, that there's help. I want them to know that we can do this, and it's even better if we do it together. All of the information that we're giving you now is for your benefit, and you're going to live and not die, and you will declare the work of the Lord. God bless you. Tracey, thank you so much. I want to thank you for joining us, and I wish you the greatest success this fall with the American Diabetes Association that's hooked up with the American Heart Association and knowdiabetesbyheart.com. That's KNOW diabetesbyheart.org. I got org there. And if you want to learn more about it, just go to that website, go to that link, and you'll find out some information that will increase your life and maybe teach you how to even eat better. Glory to God, because eating is my weakness. So thank God for you and every one of you. Let us know. Let us know how this has benefited you. Let us know how this has really made an impact on your life, because that impact on your life will increase your life for the rest of your life. God bless you. God keep you. Tracey Brown, I owe you dinner.
Thank you so much, Pastor Donnie. God bless you. God bless your listeners. Be well and stay well, my friend.